وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى in today's تفسير I want to talk about قوله تعالى the statement of Allah خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he says خذ العفو What does it mean خذ العفو It means اقبل Go towards Muhammad Allah is talking to Nabi Muhammad and he's talking to all of us as well Take with you and come with العفو forgiveness Don't be a person who is who doesn't forgive. Forgive. If you see from the people good manners, go forward with them, deal with them. And if you don't, then forgive them. The humans are like that. Either what you see from them is that which is pleasing, you come forward and you يعني, benefit, inshallah ta'ala, and you be with them. And if you see sometimes from the people that which is displeasing, then you take the quality of just forgiving them. And that's what the ayah is saying. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ Take forgiveness with you. يَعْنِي الصَّفْحُ عَنْهُ وَتَجَاوَزُهُ Forgive him. And all those bad manners and those سُوءُ الْأَخْلَاقِ and those vulgar things that you see from them. Allah says in the Qur'an, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةُ ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم الله سبحانه وتعالى he tells us سبحانه وتعالى the good and the evil are not the same ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة the good and the evil are not the same ادفع repel The evil with what? بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ That which is good. If something evil is done to you, repel it with good. Respond to it with good. فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ And if you do that, what will happen is, the person that you had animosity and evil with, when you deal with them like that, they will return good. كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ He's going to become like a close friend of yours. He done you bad, and what you responded to him with, the way you dealt with him in response, the way you responded to his evil doings is by being the better one. And if you do that, فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ The person that you had animosity or you had a problem with, what will happen is كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ He becomes like a very close, honorable friend. وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٌ Patience, brothers and sisters. Abdullah ibn Zubayr radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, Zubayr ibn Awam. He said, أَمَرَ اللَّهُ نَبِيَّهُ Allah commanded his prophet. Allah is the one who's commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah commanded him what? أَنْ يَأْخُذَ الْعَفْوَ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ That he takes forgiveness from the etiquette of the people. The way that the people deal with him, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he takes from it what? He takes from it an honorable quality, and that is he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forgives them from the people's akhlaq. They're sometimes in their things which are despicable, that which is not nice. So what do? You respond to them in good. وَلِذَٰلِكَ ibn Atiyyah he said, وَصِيَّةُ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ لِنَبِيِّهِ It's an advice from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. تَعُمُّ جَمِيعَ أُمَّتِي and encompasses the entire ummah. Okay, وَأَخْذٌ بِجَمِيعِ مَكَارِمِ الْأَخْلَاقِ Which is to take all good manners. معناه it means اقبل من الناس في أخلاقهم وأقوالهم ومعاشرتهم ما أتى عفوا دون تكلف. This is what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he told the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala instructed the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which is that from the people's manners and from the people's dealings, if there is things that are not nice, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam was commanded to what? To respond and to deal with them in that which is good, which is forgiveness. Sallallahu alayhi wasalam. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, what does it mean? أي وَأْمُرِ النَّاسَ, command the people, Muhammad, بِالْعُرْفِ أي بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, command them that which the Sharia accepts and that which the Sharia likes. الَّذِي يُقِرُّهُ الشَّرَعَ, command them that the speech and the actions which the Sharia considers good, مِنْ قَوْلٍ أو فِعْلٍ, whether it be speech or whether it be actions which the Sharia considers good, command those, the people that. It's like what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةِ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Let there be from amongst the ummah those who call to the good and that prohibit the evil, and those are the people who are successful. Those are the people who are يعني مُفْلِحُونَ. Those are the مُفْلِحُونَ. They're the ones who command the good, and they're the ones who prohibit the evil. So the Prophet here is commanded, وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, command the people what? That which is good. Then Allah says, وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ, and turn away from those who are ignorant. Turn away from them. وَأَعْرِضْ, turn away from who? عَمَّنْ جَهِلَ عَلَيْكَ, the one who's ignorant with you. If he's acting in a dim-witted way towards you, just turn away from him. The way he's dealing with you, the way he talks to you, the way he speaks about you, everything is just badi, it's filthy. Don't steep to his level. Don't have the dignity that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gives to the believers. Hold yourself accountable. It's mentioned that Fakhruddin al-Razi, he said, al-maqsoodu minhu amru al-rasooli sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi an yasbir ala su'i akhlaqihim. That the intent here is that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala commanded the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be patient upon the evil characteristics of the people. وَأَلَّا يُقَابِلَ أَقْوَالَهُمُ الرَّكِيكَةِ, and that the Prophet does not respond to their speech which is filthy. وَلَا أَفْعَالِهِمُ الْخَسِيسَةِ بِأَمْثَالِهَا, he doesn't respond to their bad words and their bad actions. He doesn't respond to it in the same way. No. وَلَيْسَ فِيهِ دَلَالَةٌ عَلَى امْتِنَاعِهِ مِنَ الْقِتَالِ, and this of course doesn't show that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam should not fight such a people. لأنه لا يمتنع أن يؤمر عليه الصلاة والسلام بالإعراض عن الجاهلين مع الأمر بقتال المشركين. This ayah does not show, he's saying, that the Prophet should not fight with the disbelievers, يعني the jihad. فحينئذ لا حاجة إلى التزام النسخ. He said this hadith ayah to be used as abrogation, it doesn't show this case. Okay? إلا أن الظاهرية من المفسرين مشغوفون بتكثير الناسخ والمنسوخ من غير ضرورة ولا حاجة. So the point I want from the ayah is that the ayah, it shows and it indicates that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was commanded to be patient with these people who are su'u akhlaq, and that you don't respond to their filthy speech and their actions with something like it. You have to turn away from them, as Allah said about the ibadur rahman, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When the ignorant people talk to them, what do they say? سَلَامًا. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, he said about them in Surah Al-Qasas, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَقَالُوا لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ لَا نَبْتَغِي الْجَاهِلِينَ. When they hear, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ, when they hear idle speech, أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ, they turn away from it. وَقَالُوا لَنَا, and they say, this is for us, أَعْمَالُنَا, our actions. وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ, and for you is your actions. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ, peace be upon you. لَا نَبْتَغِي الْجَاهِلِينَ. That's the response they give. So not every safi who talks, every dim-witted person who talks, you don't go out there and you don't respond to them. وَلِذَلِكَ, the poet, he said, إِذَا نَطَقَ السَّفِيهَ فَلَا تُجِبْهُ فَخَيْرٌ مِنْ إِجَابَتِهِ سُكُوتُهُ. If the dim-witted one talks, don't respond to him. Don't respond to him. What is better is that you don't respond to him. You're silent. Okay, another poet, he said, وَلَوْ كُلُّ كَلْبٍ عَوَى أَلْقَمْتُهُ حَجَرًا لَأَصْبَحَ صَخْرُ مِثْقَالًا بِدِينَارِ. If every dog that barked, you threw a rock at it, the value of the rock will go up. The value of the rock will go up. So if this one shouts And then another one shouts, and then another shouts, and then another one shouts, and every single person you respond to them, that's not how it is. You have to turn away from the ignorant ones. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا سَلَامًا ha. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَقَالُوا لَنَا أَعْمَالُونَ وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ لَا نَبْتَغِي الْجَاهِلِينَ. That's the response. And these are righteous people. They're ibadur rahman. This is their responses. And this is what they say. And that's what Allah is saying to us here. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, take with you afu, forgiveness. And anyone who says anything says to you, just forgive them. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ, and command the people who could. Command the people what's in the deen of Allah. Don't sugarcoat what's in the deen of Allah. Say it. هَذَا دِينُ اللَّهِ. Let the one who loves it love it, and the one who hates it hate it. And then what did Allah say? وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Turn away from the ignorant ones. The one who's safih, who doesn't know, who's ignorant, just turn away from him. The one who has bad akhlaq, turn away from him. Don't steep to his level. Don't what? Steep to his level. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he mentions, he says, قَدِيمَ عُيَيْنَةَ ibn حِسْنٍ ibn حُذَيْفَ. He came to his what? His ibn akhihi. His name was Al-Hurr ibn Qaysin. He came to him. He stayed with him. وَكَانَ مِنَ النَّفَرِ الَّذِينَ يُدِينُهُمْ عُمَرُ وَكَانَ الْقُرَّاءُ أَصْحَابَ مَجَالِسَ عُمَرَ وَمُشَاوَرَتِهِ. Umar, there was a group of people who used to be in his, يعني, in a circle. And they were the qurra, they were the scholars and the ulama. It doesn't matter whether they were young or old. It doesn't matter. كُهُولًا كَانُوا أَوْ شُبَّانًا. Whether they were young or whether they were old, it didn't matter. Umar رضي الله عنه, the person who had knowledge, was in his inner circle. He used to consult those people. So Uyayna, who came, يعني عيينة بن حسن بن حذيفة, who came to his يعني ابن أخيه, his nephew, الحرة بن قيسن, he said to حرة بن قيسن, I need a favor from you. Hey, هل لك وجه عند هذا الأمير? Do you have يعني the ability to take me to عمر بن الخطاب? فاستأذن لي عليه, ask permission so I can go into him and I want to talk to him. So الحرة بن قيسن, he went and he sought permission for him. For عيينة ابن حسن ابن حذيفة, he went and he asked permission for him. فأذن له عمر. عمر said, okay, bring him in. يعني if he wants to talk to me, he can come in. فلما دخل عليه, when عيينة ابن حسن entered onto عمر رضي الله عنه, he said to him straight away, يا ابن خطاب. He said to him, عمر, يا ابن خطاب, فوالله ما تعطينا الجزل ولا تحكم بيننا بالعدل. He says, you don't give us the al-jazal. And al-jazal, it means al-ataya al-kathira. You don't give us a lot. You're stingy. وَلَا تَحْكُمْ بَيْنَنَا بِالْعَدْلِ. And you don't judge us with justice. You don't, Umar. That's what he said. فَغَضِبَ عُمَرُ. Umar became angry. حَتَّى هَمَّ أَنْ يُقَعَ بِهِ. Umar was so angry that he wanted to grab him and do something to him. فَقَالَ لَهُ الْحُرُّ بْنُ قَيْسٍ, said to him, يَا أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Oh, the leader of the believers. إن الله تعالى قال لنبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله تبارك وتعالى, he said to his prophet, خذ العفو, take forgiveness. وأمر بالعرف, command the good. وأعرض عن الجاهلين, and turn away from the ignorant ones. وإن هذا من الجاهلين, and this one is from the ignorant ones. والله ما جاوزها عمر حين تلاها عليه وكان وقافا عند كتاب الله عز وجل. عمر رضي الله عنه, as soon as he heard the ayah recited, he didn't go forward. He didn't move forward and do anything. And look what the narration mentions. وَكَانَ وَقَافًا عِنْدَ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. Umar was one who used to يعني stand at the boundaries of Allah تبارك وتعالى like that. The Quran could stop him. Umar رضي الله تعالى. ولذلك, brothers and sisters, there are three things that you can take from the ayah. And these are three powerful points that summarizes the way that a Muslim carries himself. The number first one is, خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, be a person who forgives. Free your heart from grudges and things towards people. Forgive them. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala commanded us that. Yani, don't let a person live in your heart rent free. And when you're letting someone live in your heart without paying rent, yani you're the one who's preoccupied all day about this person and they're just out there doing, having fun, enjoying themselves. And you are here just always, no, take it out of your heart. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ, forgive, forget. That's number one. And it's a great quality to have. Because remember, brothers and sisters, forgiving others is a sign that you want Allah to forgive you. All of us, we do some sins, right? Don't we do mistakes and shortcomings? We do. So we want Allah to forgive us, so we forgive others. Number two. But by the way, brothers and sisters, before I go to the second one, it doesn't mean the person you forgive, you have to have a relationship with them. No. No. You don't have to. You can forgive someone, but say, hey, look, I don't want to have a relationship. I forgive you for what's happened in the past. I forgive you. But relationship, no. No. I'm preoccupied. I'm busy. I've got other things I need to preoccupy myself with. But I do forgive you. I have nothing against you. Yawm al-Qiyamah, nothing about me will come to you, inshallah ta'ala. I forgive you. Okay? Forgiveness is important. But having a relationship with some people, maybe it's not the healthiest thing. Because it will come to another problem and another problem. It's best maybe you go your separate ways. You do your thing, they do their thing. That's why in Islam, the concept of divorce is allowed. When two people can't get along, it's divorce, separate. But people forgive one another. Khudil afwa. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ and command one another good. So forgiveness is the first quality. The second is commanding the people the good. Especially when you're in the da'wah, brothers and sisters, leave off personal grudges that you have all day with people. Just let that go. Don't have any grudge with anybody. But busy yourself. Don't make anything personal. This is about the deen of Allah. It's not personal. And the second one is, which is command the people the good. Call to the deen of Allah. Al-urf here is that which the sharia consented to, that which the sharia is for. That's what you call the people to. The urf is what the sharia set, or what the sharia allowed. As Allah mentioned in the ayah, وَلْتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَمَا كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. That you call to the good and you prohibit the evil. So if Al-Amru bil-ma'ruf. Al-Amru bil-ma'ruf. And here it says what? خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ. عُرْفِ and ma'ruf is the same thing. The third quality, brothers and sisters, that we take from this verse is what? You come with the quality of staying away from conflicts and indulging with ignorant people. Okay? وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Turn away from the ignorant people. Some people, brothers and sisters, the truth of the matter is they're like the pig. And the pig, what is it? And why am I resembling them to the pig? I'm doing the tashbih from this perspective, inshallah. Pay attention to it. Which is that the pig, he loves to scuffle in the mud. So if someone goes to the pig and he scuffles in the mud, even if you beat the pig in a wrestling match, you go on top of them and you win, huh? The pig enjoyed that whole entire ride. He loved it. He liked what was happening, what was taking place. You on the other hand, you've scuffled in mud. Your clothes are dirty. You feel sick. But he loved the whole entire, from the beginning to the end, he loved it. Brothers and sisters, let's say you have white thobe. Might be a better example to give. You're wearing a white thobe and you're the best wrestler there is out there. Let's say you're the best wrestler there is out there. And you have somewhere important to go to. And a little kid comes up to you and says, I want to wrestle with you, whose hands are dirty. He's got mud on him. And he says, I want to wrestle with you. Does it mean that you can't wrestle when you say, look, I don't want to wrestle. I want to go. I don't want to wrestle with you. The reason is because I'm going to lose more than you. I've got more to lose here. So the person should learn this quality of turning away from the ignorant people. You can't jump on every single person. You can't. So that's what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us, a quality which is wa'arid, turn away from the ignorant ones. And don't entertain them all the time. Or else what happens is your level goes down, 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 down. Wa'arid anil jahilin. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.